Today we will study about respiration, respiratory system, its structure and function from chapter number 11, Human Body and Organ System. Now this slide is about respiration. Did you ever thought how do we write, speak, walk or move around? Why it is necessary to eat food? Why we can't do our work peacefully when we are hungry? Yes, the answer is we need energy for all our activities, which we get from the food we eat. Human being is a multicellular organism. There are many processes carried out in our body at a given time, such as digestion, respiration, circulation, excretion, etc. For these processes, different organs work in coordination. Now the question is, what is an organ? You have studied that cell is the basic unit of life. Group of cells perform a specific function and they form tissues. Tissues of different types work together to form an organ. Group of organs work together, perform specific function called as organ system. Now respiration is one of such process, or it is a part of the organ system. The human body is divided into two cavities. The upper cavity, which contains the chief organs of circulation and respiration, is known as thoracic cavity, thorax or chest. And the lower cavity, which occupies organs of digestion and excretion, is abdominal cavity. Now respiratory system is carried out in the thoracic cavity. Now what is respiration? It is a biochemical process in which the cells of an organism obtain energy by oxidation of glucose, which we obtain from the food, and it gives out carbon dioxide, water, and the energy molecules in the form of ATP. Respiratory system consists of nose, pharynx, trachea, lungs, and diaphragm. Nose. Air enters into the body through the openings of nose, known as nostrils. The nasal passage is lined with the fine hair, which helps to filter the air by trapping dust molecules or microbes. Also, there is mucus lining which traps the dust to facilitate smooth flow of air. Second part, pharynx. It is the part of throat behind the mouth and nasal cavity where food pipe and windpipe originates. Windpipe is present in front of the food pipe. There is a lid at the beginning of the windpipe. This lid gets closed while eating. During the passage of food into the food pipe, and thereby it prevents the entry of food molecules or water molecules into the windpipe. Air passes through the pharynx into the windpipe. Windpipe is also known as trachea. The windpipe bifurcates in the thorax region, and one branch enters into the right lung, the other into the left lung. A lung is present on either side of the heart in thoracic cavity. Each lung is covered by double layered pleura. This membrane protects the lungs. The trachea bifurcates into right lung and left lung as bronchus. The bronchus then divides into smaller and smaller tubes known as bronchioles. These bronchioles end up into a small air pocket known as alveoli. There are many, many small alveoli in the lungs. These alveoli helps to increase the surface area available for gaseous exchange. The exchange of gases which takes place in the lungs. You can see the diagram over here. The bronchus is getting divided into bronchioles. Bronchioles is getting divided into alveoli. Alveoli is covered by a rich supply of blood. For gaseous exchange to take place, blood is continuously circulating around the alveoli. In the blood, we have hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a protein which helps to absorb the oxygen from the inhaled air. The inhaled air is rich in oxygen, and the blood which is surrounding the alveoli, it is rich in carbon dioxide. There is a pressure difference between the walls of alveoli and the blood capillaries. So what happens? Oxygen immediately diffuses into the blood capillaries which is surrounding the alveoli, and carbon dioxide immediately diffuses from the capillaries into the alveoli. Now this air is rich in carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide has come from the cellular respiration. It is also having some water molecules, as any cellular respiration will give out both carbon dioxide and water vapor. When this air is exhaled out of the nose, it is rich in carbon dioxide and water vapor. There is a muscular partition present between the thoracic and abdominal cavity known as diaphragm. This diaphragm plays a very important role during the mechanism of breathing. At the time of breathing, you must have felt the ribs rises upward and outward. Therein, the diaphragm becomes flattened. Because of this, the air pressure in the lungs decreases, the volume in the lungs increases. Immediately, the air from outside rushes inside and inhalation takes place, which is also known as inspiration. The second part, exhalation or expiration. During expiration, the ribs return to their original position and diaphragm rises up. So the pressure in the lungs increases. As soon as the pressure increases, the air moves out through the nose. Continuous upward and downward movement of the diaphragm is necessary to bring out the breathing. Today we have seen the explanation of respiratory system. Respiratory system consists of 5 main parts: nose, pharynx, trachea, lungs, and diaphragm. The small compartments in the lungs is known as alveoli. The walls of alveoli and capillaries are extremely thin. This allows gaseous exchange easily to take place around the alveoli. You can see the activity. Try to solve this activity. Thank you.